Hi guys, welcome back to Crypto Games for another video. You ain't gonna believe what I just did. I just done a whole video on this video that I'm about to show you and then I deleted it. What a stupid idiot. Anyway guys, I'm gonna have to do it again because it was such an interesting video, and we're gonna be looking at Zilliqa, and it's basically answering that question. I can't believe I'm saying all this again, bloody hell. Anyway, it's that question that everybody wants to know. How much Zilliqa should you own? Okay, you know, should you have, should you buy? So this is the question we're going to be answering, and if this is something that you're interested in, you know, drop that like, give me some subscribes, and I'm going to dive into this again. Oh god, I can't believe I just deleted it, my god. But yeah, before I do get into this, I'm not a financial advisor. These are just my own personal opinions on the market, so please always do your own research before investing any money. Okay, I can't believe I'm doing this again. Why did I delete it? Anyway, guys, so if you're new watching to me, what I do on my channel is I do a few things. I take it when it comes to deciding, you know, how much should you have? You have to know your goal. And the average person usually has a goal of like 10,000 coins, or sorry, 10,000 pounds or dollars. I'm going to be doing dollars as well, 100,000 pounds or £1 million. So we're going to look at these targets, and then this will give you a better understanding of how many coins you need. Okay. So if you had, let's just grab up the goal of 10,000. If you had a goal of 10,000 pounds, yeah, and again, I'm going to do it in dollars. The price right now is a penny. But let's have a look at Zilliqa's all-time high. Zilliqa's all-time high right now was 15 pence. It was 15 pence as high as it went. Now, let me just show you that in dollars, right? 15 pence in dollars is 20 cents. That's how high Zilliqa went, yeah? So to work out how many coins you need, this is what we'd do. So a little burp there. You'd have £10,000 goal, and you'd divide that by 0.15. That would be a total of 66,666 coins that you would need, okay? And again, that's just based off of it hitting its all-time high of 15 pence, 20 cents, yeah? Obviously, after this, I'm going to take you through, again, the realistic gains of what I believe Zilliqa can hit, because I really do believe it can go higher than this price here, yeah? So 66,666 is what you'd need to reach that $10,000 goal. And that's for people that, you know, if you're in uni and you just want to pay off your loan, or, you know, you want to buy a nice car, someone that doesn't want to be in too long but is happy to sort of get your £10,000 in and out, done. That's what that's for, yeah? So let's just quickly do this in dollars now. So 10,000, obviously, and then you divide that by 0.20, because I said it was 20 cents. You'd be looking at 50,000 coins that you'd need to hold, yeah? So that's that one. If you had a goal of £100,000, now this is the goal where for me it's life changing, because if you know £100,000, you could buy yourself a nice little house on the side, or a studio flat, and you can rent out stuff. You know, this for me is life changing money for some people. So if there is anyone out there that has that goal, this is how many coins you would need. Okay, again, based on just it here, and it's all time high of 15 pence, 666666. We can kind of see the pattern here. Yeah? 666,666. Now the question you have to ask yourself is that doable for the average person? Because that based on, you know, hitting it all-time high, that might not be very doable. And just to show you an example of this, when I say doable, you know, if you had £1,000, right, £1,000, and you divide it by the price of what it is today, because for me, I always say, you know, the average person should probably be able to afford £1,000 in their lifetime to invest, right? So if you had £1,000 and you divide it by, you know, 0.14 today, that would basically give you around 71,000. So it's you know, it's about almost what, six, maybe nine times higher than the average person could afford. And don't get me wrong, I am an average person, you know. So, you know, and I look at it and I think, well, maybe 666,000 might be a long stretch in trying to reach that sort of number. But that's just, again, we're just being very real. I'm showing you based on the data that I see, and that's sort of like the goal you would need, okay? Let me just show you this in dollars. 100,000, and you divide it by 0.20. Remember I said 20 cents, which is the dollars here. 500,000 coins. Again, might not be doable for the average person, but there might be people out there that already has this amount of coins, you know? So, but yeah, so that's the 100,000 mark. Let's now dive into that 500,000, because there's always people that want to have this sort of money. And again, we're only basing it off of its all-time high of 15 pence, 20 cents. So if your goal was £500,000, this is how many coins you would need. We divide it by 0.15, 15 pence. That gives you a total of 3,333,333 pence. Pounds. pence, 33 pence. Anyway, yeah, free. Again, to me, that's very out of the realm of possibility for the average person, you know, because your time's in, like, I don't know how much thousands that is, but that, you know, you need 3 million coins. So let's just check this in dollars. So it's the 500,000 mark, wouldn't it? What I might do, because usually I do the 250,000, but I'm going to do that after I show you how high realistically Zilliqa can go, because I really do believe it can see higher numbers. And obviously that means that the coins would be less. We won't need as much coins. So yeah, 500,000, if you had that goal, $500,000, we divide that by, we divide it by 20 cents, 2.5 million coins is what you'll need, okay? Again, it might be, some people might already have that number, I don't know, but if you don't sweat it, because again, I'm going to show you the difference. Now we're going to dive into that 1 million mark. If you have a goal of 1 million pounds, now a lot of people want to be a millionaire when they're in crypto. You know, everybody wants to become wealthy and have that sort of number. So if you're looking to hit the million and you're patient enough to wait for Zilliqa to bloom and, you know, grow adoption and things like that, because not just that, again, there's a lot more to Zilliqa. Like, you know, you've got the stake inside and the GZIL coins. If you don't know about Zilliqa, they got this, you know, one GZIL coin can turn into 3,000 ZIL coins, and so there's so many more ways to make money on this, but I'm gonna have to leave that for another video. Yeah, but if you had a target of £1 million just based off it hitting its all-time high, did I yeah, 15 pence was 20 cents, so let's do it in pounds first, divide that by 0.15. I think we already know the number, don't we? 6 million coins, roughly 6.6 million coins. Yeah, again, that might be very out of the realm of the possibility for the average person, but if you have that sort of number, then great on you. It is hard to hit, not gonna lie. Now let's have a look for the dollars quickly. So I think it's gonna be 2.5, isn't it? Let's have a look, divide that by 0.20. oh, sorry, 5 million coins is what you're going to need. Yeah, and again, that's just off of it hitting 15 pence. Now look, I believe Zilliqa is really going to hit a much higher price than what it is, and let me show you why, right? What I do in my videos, if you haven't seen, is I always look at its total supply, yeah? Because the total supply kind of shows me more realistically how high it can go. Now, Zilliqa has a total supply of almost 14 billion coins, yeah? Now, I've grabbed this coin here, Ravain, because it is very similar in its supply. Have a look here, 12.4, almost 13 billion, yeah? Now, Ravain hit an all-time high of, where are we? Let's have a look. Well, that's not even at its mountain. That's not at the peak of the mountain, but right there, £3. Where is it? £3.04. That's how high it hit. So when I look at a coin like this, and again, 13 billion, you know, Zilliqa, 14 billion, very, very similar. It's just shy of a billion or just over a billion, yeah? When I look at it, I think if this coin can do this, then, you know, Zilliqa can very well hit the similar prices, because this is telling me that the money has been there before. So if the money's been in there before, it can easily come back again and it can easily flow into any coin, okay? So that's my reasoning for that. But let's just go on the basis, because Zilliqa has just a little bit, a smidge more, a billion more coins. So let's just go on the basis that maybe it might not hit £3. Maybe it might go just a little bit lower. Maybe it might go like 260, or, you know, I'm gonna be really real here. What's this down here? What's this right down here? £2.08. We can even call it two. Even if Zilliqa hit something like that, £2, yeah. And just to show you this in dollars, what £2 is. £2 is $2.60, yeah. Even if it hits something like that, because again, that's being very realistic. I'm not jumping at the peak of its mountain of what Ravain done. I'm showing you like a really lowish sort of drop to where it was. You would still see some crazy gains, right? And you won't need as much coins. Now check this, because it now changes the whole mindset as to how many coins you'd need. So if you had that £10,000 goal, and then it hit, you know, and we divide that by two. Oh, what am I doing? Cannot divide by zero. Done that wrong. So if you had that £10,000 goal, we divide it by two, obviously, £2, you would only need 5,000 coins. Now that is very doable for the average person, you know? Just put them hobnobs away. Don't pick them up in the store. Put them down. Don't buy no chocolate. And just invest. Get yourself a nice little 10 grand there, because then that will cover your car or your uni, your student uni loan, whatever it is that you need that 10 grand for, yeah? Now just to show you this in dollars real quick. So $10,000. I said it was $2.60, right? See it there? That's the conversion rate. So if you had that goal of £10,000 and you're happy, you get your £10,000 and you're gone, you would only need to accumulate 3,846 coins. Do you see how different it is, like from hitting the 15 to, and again, I really believed it can see £2, even higher. But yeah, 3,846 coins. Now let's go on to the $100,000 mark. If you had a goal of £100,000, $100,000, we're doing pounds first. We divide that by two. I can only tell you simple math, 50,000 coins. And again, that is very doable for the average person to get 50,000, to get £100,000. Now let me just show you as an example, right? Because look, if you had £1,000 today, this is just an example. If you had £1,000 today and then you bought Zilliqa at the price that it is today, which is like what, a penny, just over a penny, 0.14, yeah, 0.14, you would get 71,000 coins. So you know, if your goal is 100,000, that you've passed that. You've like already gone past it, just the base of it hitting, you know, investing £1,000 today. So, and again, that's based on it hit, you only need 50,000, and it's based on it hitting, you know, the £2 mark, and I really believe it can. So yeah, let's just quickly do this in dollars. So if you have that goal for $100,000, you want to go out there and get yourself into real estate and buy a couple of studio apartments and stuff, and you know, rent them out. Because that's what most people have for this, for this £100,000 goal. You know, you can do a lot with it. Let's divide that by $2.60 is what I said. You would only need, I say only again, because like £1,000 is 71,000 coins, 38,461 coins. That is very doable for the average person. Let's have a look at the 250,000 mark. Because again, I was going to do the 500, but I want to do 250,000. Because some people might not want to wait to 500,000. You might see, because if you look down at your portfolio app, whatever you have, and you see £250,000 or $250,000 sitting there looking at you, or if it's looking at me, you best believe I'm going to take some of that, because there's no way I'm going to let that drop and lose it all. So if you saw this and this was your goal, and you know, you wanted to buy like a nice boat and a nice little house and things like that, this is how much you would need. Let's divide that by two. Very simple math, 125,000 coins. Is again, me personally, I believe that's very doable for the average person. You know, just stop going out, don't buy them Chinese takeaways, don't buy no egg fried rice, black bean sauce, because that's what I buy. Just get yourself some beans on toast. Hey, Alexa, yeah, beans on toast today, yeah. Okay, how long? 5 minutes, yeah, Alexa. Just get yourself some beans on toast and just don't eat out so much. That's what I'm trying to say, because I don't know if you guys are the same, but I tend to eat out a lot, and I don't need to. I keep wasting this money, and I just think to myself, I could put this in other things, like Zilliqa, for example. So yeah, if that's your goal, £250,000 is life changing, man. For some, let's check this in dollars now. Yeah, 250,000. If that was your goal, like I said, $2.60, and just so you can see it here again, see, that's the conversion rate, £2 to $2.60. And again, that was only just going on with Vane's little drop here. I really do believe it can hit the same sort of numbers. But yeah, if you had that goal, £250,000, you would need 96,153 coins. I mean, if this is helping anyone right now, you know, really trying to help you as to what kind of coins you need, drop a like, let me know, because it's helping me at the minute to really decide, you know, what kind of figure, you know, you want to achieve, what kind of number, price you want to cash out on and stuff. Anyway, let's check the 500,000. Now that is a game changing number there, you know, because if you have £500,000, you can do so much. Half a million, come on. So let's divide this by two. Very easy math there. 250,000 coins is what you'd need if you're in the UK. And let's just do this in dollars. So if you had that 500,000 goal, you divide that by $2.60, which again, that's been very, I think I was being very generous there when I was saying hitting the £2 mark, because I really do believe it can go higher based on this sort of supply that it has there. Where have I gone? Here we go. Yeah. Oh, what's happened? Zero. You'd need zero. Let's do it again. This is the 500,000 mark, right? 500,000, and you divide that by $2.60. You would need 192,307 coins. Now, some of you may already have that. you may already have this amount. If you do, you should be smiling, because again, you know, you could potentially be sitting on something like £500,000 or $500,000. Damn, man, it's life-changing money. So yeah, I'm obviously going to do another video showing you how much it's going to cost. This video is just to show you how many coins you'd need, yeah? So that's what this is showing here. Let's just dive into that final one, the £1 million mark, because everybody wants to be a millionaire. How much would it cost you? So we know the basic math here. You divide it by £2, 500,000 coins would be the goal that you'd need to achieve £1 million. Potentially £1 million, you know, based on it hitting the all-time highs of £2. And again, like I've said, the money's been there before. It can come again into any project. And they have similar supplies. So if that's your goal, 500,000 coins, let's just finally check this in dollars, and then I'll be out of your way and you don't have to worry about this video anymore. I'm sorry it's been long, but it's one of those ones where, you know, it's we're talking about investing serious money. This isn't a joke in my eyes, so I didn't want to rush it a second time around. I need to show you and really take my time on this to show you the realistic goals of what we need to achieve. So if you had that goal of £1 million, and again, you know, you divide it by 2.60 cents, you'd need 384,615 coins. Again, that could be doable. Again, there might be people already invested into that that has that, because some people invest more than £1,000 or £2,000, and that's just based off, like, you know how long would it take to hit these prices with the being a penny and stuff. We might be lucky and see it drop down here again, like the 2002, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people accumulated when it was around this price, 002 and things like that. But yeah, that is the sort of number you're going to need to achieve £1 million in my eyes. You know, Zilliqa could go higher. I'm just saying £2, guys, it could go higher, but I just showed you that based off of what I see with Ravain and a similar supply, you know, 13-14 billion, very, very similar. And yeah, so sorry to be long on this one. It was something that I had to do again because I bloody deleted the last video. Then I was determined to do it because I really like Zilliqa. This project's so interesting and there's so much ways to make money on it. I will obviously have to do a video on the staking side of things as well, because like I said, these GZIL coins, you know, for one GZIL coin, there's like 3,000 coins. So ZIL coins, and it is good. But yeah, guys, I hope you liked this. I hope it did help someone. Please let me know your thoughts on this and what goals you're looking to reach and stuff. Drop some comments down below. Give me a like, give me a subscribe, and I will look forward to seeing you guys in my next video. Thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.